I've been farming here now for 25 years. I've done a lot of motorsport, riding motorbikes, sidecars, and, you know, just enjoyed life to the full, basically.
His outlook on life has changed. He's just a different person to what he used to be. Very grumpy, very miserable.
We used to, you know, go down to the Royal Welsh Show for 4 days. We go to other shows, go for days off here, days off there, do, you know, go for a walk and that sort of thing.
You know, Dad, he could walk. He could walk, like. So, you know, now we never go anywhere, do we?
Or used to go into a pub at a night or a party, and I used to be up at the bar all night socialising. I'd like to talk to everybody in the room, you know, a real sociable person.
Now he sits in the corner with me, and of course I feel I've got to stay with him, isn't it, to keep him company. And people don't come and approach Roger like Roger used to go and approach them.
I came up across here with a quad. I went up that little hill there, and that's where the accident happened. I went up a little hill that I shouldn't have gone up, basically. Took a shortcut. I remember putting the quad in four-wheel drive, getting to the top of the hill, and the bike actually started to grab on the front wheels. It was spinning on the front wheels. So I tried reversing back, and as it was reversing back, it started to come up. It flicked me on the ground, and the next thing I knew, bang, it landed on top of me. I shouldn't have done it. All I needed to do was go down that pathway down there, back up, 2 minutes of madness, and a lifetime of misery, basically. I remember the ambulance coming and the air ambulance coming. And believe me, the air ambulance is a fantastic thing. I remember going to Hereford, that was including taking off and landing, it was 15 minutes. They had to stabilise me first because the pelvic fracture is obviously life-threatening, which I didn't know it was. So they put me in traction then for 6 days in Hereford to stabilise me. Then took me to Coventry. I was all pinned up in Coventry.
This is the fracture, look. This is the front part of your pelvis, and there's the pins after. Mostly when you get this sort of damage, apparently it cuts your main artery to your legs, and you have internal bleeding, and of course you don't survive it.
I came back home from hospital. I was pretty well bedridden for 3 months. The long-term impact on my life is pretty detrimental, actually. You're feeling yourself, you're just helpless, totally helpless. You know, you're lucky, you can't even get yourself a cup of tea. I can't walk around, I've got to sit most of my time. You know, I find it really hard going. I'm a livestock farmer, I can't do much sheep work. My social life is pretty poor, really. I can't go nowhere. My hobbies, as I say, used to race bikes. I don't even like going to watch racing bikes because I want to be doing it. And the other big impact is, of course, I can't drive a tractor anything much. Because, you know, the action of a tractor, when you're going across a rough field or even on a rough road, you know, it goes like that and it goes like that at the same time. And I just, you know, I just got so much muscle and tissue damage that I struggle with it all. From one point of view, it's just ruined my life, you know. When you're actually doing something, you've actually got to think about what you're doing. Concentrate on the moment in time and not on something else, you know. I wasn't wearing no headgear. The rest of my clothing was suitable for the job I was doing. But, you know, you should have been wearing a helmet, really. And the other big thing is, you've really got to think of where you're taking these machines, and where I went was stupid. Nothing more than stupidity, you know. I just shouldn't have been there. So I shouldn't have went up there in the first place. You know, it's just 2 minutes of madness.